What is going on, guys? We are back with another video, and of course, if you could tell by the title of the video, we're doing a top 10 positional changes in Madden 18, and of course, we're probably going to miss a few. Maybe you guys have ones that you go to all the time. Let me know if I miss any in this video, but these are the top 10 that I like for rebuilds or just, you know, for use, whatever it may be. Of course, let's move on to the first one. These aren't necessarily in any particular order. They are, but they aren't, you know, like... Some of them are just not ordered properly. Kinda. I mean, we'll put it that way. Number one, or 10 anyways, Braxton Miller. Of course, wide receiver. A lot of people know about this. But if he goes to quarterback, he does drop. He does drop. He's a 64 overall, but he was only a 71 overall at wide receiver anyways. But he's 24 years old at quarterback. 21. Well, I mean, he's 24 years old, whether or not he's at quarterback. But 91 speed, 94 excel, or agility, 92 excel. Elusiveness, you know, all the way across the board, kind of a, you know, 88 base. And his throw power and all that, it's not too bad. 83 throw power is a little low, but short 77, 71 mid, 68 deep, 79 throw on the run. I mean, the only other guy you're really going to get similar to Braxton for running is, of course, Mariota. But he's going to be a little bit harder to trade for, let's say that to the least. Now we have number 9, Thomas Davis Sr., 85 overall, at as a right outside linebacker. We all know he pretty much retires after the first year every single time. And of course, when you're usering, or you're not usering, but when you're using a player for a rebuild, we all know safety, a lot harder to upgrade. They don't get awards, they don't get any of that stuff. So if you're just trying to fill them in for the win, you put him at safety, he goes up 8 overalls to 93. Then you trade for a linebacker, whatever it might need, you know, a young player, play outside linebacker, Gossie's way too excited about Thomas Davis moving positions, and you know, you develop him there, because obviously, like I said, linebacker gets the awards, they get the XP a lot easier than the safety position. But Thomas Davis, a clear cut beast, 93 overall fill-in at strong. Now I could be biased here, but the move you guys probably see in our Cowboys CFM, Ty Montgomery, of course, 80 overall running back for the Packers, 24 years of age, 90 speed, 94 acceleration. Pretty decent stats for making moves. Not quite what you're looking for as a running back, especially with Aaron Jones there, you know, and running back being the easiest position to get in all of Madden, basically in all of football. You know, why not move Ty Montgomery to wide receiver, who used to play there, of course. He goes from an 80 overall halfback to a 78 overall wide receiver. And the best part about him is he has quick development trade already. And this is, like I said, this is a move you see in our CFM. I traded for Ty Montgomery. He's our number 2 wide receiver at the moment. And with that quick dev, he's definitely going to develop pretty quickly. 6 foot tall, 222. And of course, another huge part about him that a lot of people probably wouldn't notice at first is, of course, his blocking stats. 55 impact, 58 run block, 62 pass block. Basically the best blocker on the Packers as a wide receiver. Cobb's all right in the run, I suppose, but... Across the board, Ty Montgomery gets it done as a wide receiver. Now we have another position going from running back to wide receiver to running back. Cordarrelle Patterson, obviously a very common move. 26 years of age, still a little bit of youth there, to an 82 overall as a running back. And honestly, his elusiveness style stats are pretty much unparalleled. I mean, if we look at all across the NFL, I don't know how many guys are going to get it done better than him. You got Le'Veon Bell, I guess, is pretty damn good. But, I mean, even him, he's, like, barely better. I mean, honestly, you could debate he's barely better because elusiveness is so much more expensive than spin, juke. I know stiff arm is obviously in trucking, but obviously Le'Veon Bell is the best running back in Madden versus Cordarrelle Patterson, who is a 76 overall wide receiver. I mean, you look at some of the lower guys and none of them compare. They don't compare. And he's so tall, too, 6'2". And he's obviously got the receiving stats as well, so a great number there, great player to switch up. Now we have number 6, I believe we're on number 6, Byron Jones. Obviously a pretty damn good free safety for the Cowboys, but a lot of people probably should know this one too. But he moves over to an 80 overall at cornerback. I know that's down 3, but most rosters he does usually go up, so I don't know what, you know, what he's been doing lately, but he usually does go up overall, not down. But an 80 overall nonetheless, 6 foot tall, very fast player, 96 agility as well, so he should be able to play damn well. in the slot, whatever you need him to play, really. But the main reason why I'd want him at cornerback more is if you look at his tackling and hit power, that's really cornerback-like stuff. I want some hit power for my free safety and whatnot, and that's just not going to happen with Byron Jones. And his man coverage is 79, his zone is 78. So really, couldn't put him either way. But especially, you know, as the Cowboys, I probably would keep him at safety. But we're talking from a rebuild standpoint, trading for your team on a franchise, fantasy draft, whatever it might be. Byron Jones at corner is a pretty solid move. Now at number five, we have the entire offensive interior, well, interior offensive line moving to tackle. As you guys can see here, right tackle is a position of need. Tons and tons of players under 85 overall. And of course, you see a lot of great right guards here. Also great, you know, some great centers. A lot of players, if not all of them on the interior, will go up as a tackle. So you see the likes of Alex Mack, you know, number one or number two as a center, moves up to number one easily as a right tackle. And most of the positions are going to do that as well. I know some guys, you know, you want your speed, but you look at the tackles right here, he's on par with the rest of them, and he's an old man. So a lot of these guys, great players to move over to tackle, and they're also obviously a very important position. We all know that left outside spot is going to eat up your right tackle, so that's why we have, you know, on our CFM, we have Zach Martin playing a 98 overall as a right tackle, and obviously he has quite a bit of speed to get it done, so that's our number five. Now, number four, you guys probably seen this one coming. Well, not, I don't know why I said that. You definitely didn't see this one coming. Larry Fitzgerald, obviously you can do it with a lot of different wide receivers, you know, Mike Evans, whatnot, but I'm going with Larry Fitzgerald here because one, he's 6'3", two, he's old, so he's about to retire pretty soon, and three, he's got low speed stats, unless I already mentioned that as one of the options. But the biggest reason, I suppose, that you would want him as a tight end is his blocking. I believe he has a 70 blocking, and more importantly, he jumps to a 97 overall. He goes from the like 12th wide receiver ranked to the number two tight end, right behind Rob Gronkowski. And like I said, that speed, he really doesn't have a lot of speed, so you know, he becomes a bit more of an option at tight end, I think. I think it was used to be a pretty big move in Madden before they limited us to that. Pass block's not too hot, but not hot. Your man's not hot. 70 run block, 68 impact. Very great player there as a tight end. You know, not many people are going to be fiending over Larry Fitzgerald as a wide receiver option, but as a tight end, 97 overall, you can't really go wrong there. Number three, this might be a little high, but Stephon Tuitt, 83 overall as a left end. And of course, if you move him over to defensive tackle, he moves up to an 86 overall. You know, these top ranks, they don't necessarily mean, you know, by overall who is the highest or who makes the biggest jump, but just ones that I really like, and I love Stephon Tuitt as a defensive tackle. He's just amazing there, and that is our number three. Nothing really more to say there. Now, number two, not something you probably would have expected, and not necessarily something that's going to stay, but as of right now, I'm loving the Bills' safeties to cornerback. Jordan Poyer, 86 overall, strong safety. You move him over to cornerback, and he does not move a single overall. And, you know, I might say, well, that's not really much of a change. Well, it kind of is, because, yeah, he might be decent as a strong safety, but you look at his man coverage. That's 86 man coverage. That's pretty much going to go to waste. 86 man, 89 zone. I'm not saying as the Bills that you should switch them to cornerback, but just in general, I would switch him to cornerback. Also, I guess, it's kind of like a sub, honorable mention, is most free strong safeties, the free safety. Most of them do go up in overall. You can see there, Poyer went up two. Now, Hyde, he drops a little bit more of an overall from 89 to an 86, but once again, it's that factor of, A, hit power. You know, these guys don't have great hit power. And B, the man coverage, 87 man, 87 zone. You know, he's kind of, you know, the man coverage is kind of going to a waste there at safety. I know you can catch him in man here and there, but it's kind of going to waste. So if you are missing that man coverage corner, not saying that it works for the Bills, because the Bills, I think, are pretty perfect the way they are. But I still think very valid at number two, because it's two players on the same team. Don't have to go too far to make that move. And number one, I don't know where he is. Number one, it had to be the man. If it wasn't number one, you guys would have been so mad at me. Deion Buchanan, 77 overall as a middle linebacker. and as a strong safety who moves all the way up to an 88 overall. Very fast. I mean, he's a great player for middle linebacker, don't get me wrong, but the agility is a little low, I'll say. I'm not saying that most linebackers have top-tier agility, but someone with 89-plus speed usually does have, you know, that top-tier agility, which obviously allows you to strafe and whatnot. Great hit power for, you know, any of the positions you want to play him at, but as a safety, I mean, for anyone that does rebuilds and whatnot, we all know that this is how to be number one. Clearly, clear as day, Deion Buchanan as a number one positional change. I mean, he goes from 88 down to 77. Let's see if he goes anywhere. I'm pretty sure his cornerback rating is really terrible. And obviously, another couple of honorable mentions is the likes of Khalil Mack anywhere. Oh, 78, you know, not bad. 76 overall, probably the highest hitting cornerback in the league, just like that. Not a bad overall, surprisingly, even though his man coverage is really bad. Tyrann Mathieu could have been on this list, too, if it was last year, because he used to be really great, but not this year. Deion Buchanan actually drops as a free safety. I think I do remember that happening. Tyrann Mathieu, though, look at his coverage stats. They used to be so good. It was like 82, man, 87 zone. He would have definitely been on this list. It would have probably been the Cardinals at number two instead and the Bills at number three, but still, obviously, Deion Buchanan, number one, clear as day. If I missed anyone, once again, let me know in the comment section. If you have any what-if or experiment ideas, let me know that as well. Got to do a rebuild for Saturday. Haven't done that yet, so let me know what team you want to see there. And if you want to see a fantasy style or realistic or whatnot, I usually just go back and forth because no one really cares the preference usually. But yeah, biggest thing in the comment section, let me know if you if there was one that I missed that was really big or one that you just enjoy, you know, like Dre Archer as a cornerback. He had 10 picks for me 1 year. I don't know, whatever you might think up. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Maybe like the video, subscribe if you're new. I don't, whatever. Hopefully you guys come back for next video. But until next video, three videos tomorrow at least. See ya!